two, like to 10 to 14. And I'll just say that I think I know how to, like, I'm probably going to do half of section three for the next one. The fuck? It wouldn't go in. What's happening? Is it because I was playing CE?
Our foe is more devious than we imagined. That spire was indeed a teleporter linked to a cloaked Covenant supercarrier. A grave threat. Thankfully, help is imminent.
So, chapter 10 is like the first mission of the Spartans, where like every Spartan,
Enemy
like
transport
Sam,
on
Fred,
approach. Launch facility.
Kelly, the other lady, I don't remember her name. Window, yeah, that's her name. Are going on a mission to stop rebels. I'm actually wondering when Chief found out that they actually were supposed to stop human rebellion and not to fight the Covenant.
Hostiles in the rooms to the Red Saber airborne. Boy changes the spot.
We got a raid from the lower platform!
Controls right through that door, Commander.
Okay. But yeah, Uther went to go and stop the rebellion stuff. But it's not really important to it. Like, nothing really happens.
George,
like, at all.
Six, get to the saber.
Besides, like, just capturing the rebel leader. That's pretty much it. And yeah. That's pretty much it. For chapter 10. And chapter 11 is kind of... Oh yeah, it's the first explanation of the Covenant. And also the goodbye to Chief Nimitz, the person that was training the Spartans to be military soldiers before the augmentations. It's actually pretty sad that the final conversation between him and Chief, he gives him something that meant a lot to Chief. The coin. The Halsey gave him. And it's kind of sad that even at the end of the chapter it says they never met again.
I'm
like, what if they did? What if he's still alive? Probably retired, but what if he's still alive? And that's what he's saying. But the main thing about the final bits of this section is that things are going to change and nothing will stop that. I mean, literally, Chief was ripped from his family. He had to change his entire outlook on life, his personality. I mean, literally, at the beginning of the book, he was kind of a brat. Literally, he thought that if he did it on his own, he could win the game. But when he lost it, he learned that he probably should have relied on a team instead of himself.
Understood, Colonel. Double Six, these sabers have been customized for orbital defense. You may need to get reacquainted. Rendezvous at Anchor 9 with Frigate Savannah and the other sabers as soon as you're ready. Hollowed out.
He didn't really just do anything. Like, and this is, like, and he changed his entire outlook. And he's been on a schedule since he was 6. And everyone was used to it and it wanted to get back to it after the augmentations, but after they were all done, they couldn't go back to those usual sections because they were done training. They couldn't do anything anymore. They couldn't train with each other. They didn't have a schedule besides war. That's pretty sad.
Savannah actual to Saber teams, be advised, we have bogeys
inbound. And that was what Chief Menace told Chief, that things are going to change, and he couldn't stop it. And also, Chief has changed. He isn't a brat. He's actually... He even sees the rest of Spartans as his own family. Even more sad because the Covenant, because First Contact is just happening, if you remember. And, the captain was pretty stupid thinking these aliens don't have superior human technology. superior. So let us attack. And it didn't do shit. Well, yeah, it's actually pretty sad. But,
Saber teams, use your guns to take down their shields.
Oh, yeah,
I
was talking about
the phone.
Chief, like, doesn't feel safe when he's separated from those who spawn. I died from the antenna.
Thank you.
And also, this is the first time that Chief ever saw his legendary Mjolnir. I mean, it's not the first one. Well, it's kind of the first one. But not the regular one that everyone likes. But yeah, so Chief, Kelly, and Sam, they decided, hey, why don't we just do something completely insane? There's even a reference to the "I won't miss" line from the second game. When Chief said, "I can't miss." It was on normal.
Is there any place the Covenant isn't?
Anchor 9 to all UNSC ships. Station defenses are back.
You know what? I'm just gonna end this. Yeah. But yeah, the game, I mean, no, but yeah, Sam died, I mean, his fate was sealed, like, since, I mean, his fate was already sealed, mostly because we all knew that Master Chief was the last of the Spartans, but it is pretty sad when Master Chief finally realizes that he can't hold on to everyone, so... Yeah.
Noble Six, the Savannah's countermeasures won't work forever. Find a way inside and permanently disable that cruiser's communications. As soon as we're sure the Corvette can't squawk, we'll initiate Uppercut Phase 2.
It's actually a pretty sad scene when Master Chief, when Kelly tries to get him to not do it, and he's like, I don't even know how to take this thing off. I guess it's sort of like George, like his death, but it's more and more realizing that, this is more a this book is more of an origin story for Chief than the actual fall of Reach. So, I think this is the shortest one yet, mostly because I don't think I need to actually complete the mission. So everyone, see y'all next time. Bye. That's all I have to say about the rest of it. Bye.